Sarah gets you on
so
this
before
one
we
too.
Start with the medication, we actually I want to try to see if the vagal maneuvers do work. Some people it works. If it works, then for you, you learn how to take care of this yourself if this ever happens again.
Okay.
Vagal maneuvers means like when you go to the bathroom and you poop and you're very constipated, you have to push really hard. What that does is it slows your heart rate down. So if you do that for me, you're going to take a deep breath.
I did that in the ambulance.
It didn't work? Okay. Well, let's try it again, just for kids, while she gets ready. I'm going to take a deep breath, and you're going to imagine you're pushing my arm out. Push my arm out. Push, 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 push. As much as you can bear. And...
Mess me over there.
Okay. Because it made you cough. Did they also do the massage in the neck? No. Sometimes what we do is, and this is things that I like to teach anyway, because if you're at home, you can try it, especially if it just starts. You just go around here, where you take your pulse, and then you start massaging like so. What that does is there's a carotid sinus there, there's a bunch of nerve fibers in the little dilated vessel, and when it gets stimulated, you can slow your heart rate down. That's why when the karate things and they hold the people's necks, they pass out because they put pressure there and it makes their pressure drop as well as their heart rate. The other things you can try at home are take an ice bucket with water and put your head on it, and the cold sometimes it does it and it slows you down. Alright, so we're going to start with the 6 milligrams of adenosine. You're going to feel really sick initially. The medicine kind of resets your clock, and until the clock starts again, you feel like you're passing out. So a lot of people complain it's almost like a terrible feeling.
I don't want that. I already kind of felt that way. You're pushing. Okay, 6 of adenosine.
So the most important thing about the push is that we do the flush.
They do the flush in the ambulance.
Ready?
Yeah,
all right, sweetie.
Okay, we're pushing right now, 11:21. And we raise the arm up to make it go faster. This medicine only lasts in your system a few seconds, so if we don't push it hard enough, it just doesn't do anything. Often we have to go to double that dose to make sure enough medicine gets into you. And there we go.
Okay, here it goes. Make you feel weird. It's okay. It's all right. Working.
You're doing good, sweetie.
You're doing great.
Then what I like to do is follow it with some beta blocker, some low presser to keep it slow, being applied with low presser.
Okay.
You did great.
And it's probably from, you said you were taking this decongestion for the cough?
I've only done one application.
And like she took it, 15 minutes later she had a bad headache, then after that she felt the pressure and the heart going fast and a little short of breath. So right now it's sinus, but it's still fast, 123, couple extra beats you can see right here. But that's because your heart's still irritated. I mean, it was just 3 times what the normal rate should be. And now it's still about 50% faster than it should be. So the low pressure is going to slow you down even more. You're going to feel better. In terms of the workup right now, we're going to do a little bit of blower, check your hemoglobin, your electrolytes, sodium, potassium. And since it was going since 9 a.m., which is almost 2 hours at that rate, you want to make sure you didn't have a heart attack or something from it. And then we'll do another EKG now that it's slowed down. Let me cover this up here. So that's the first EKG. And a little bit of ST depressions here, and that usually is just rate related because it's going so fast that it can look like ischemia. Right there. A little bit of ST depressions there and there. There. So we're going to do another EKG. So this is the EKG after the low pressor is back to 80-something beats per minute. No signs of ischemia. Remember the ST depressions that were here, they're now gone because they were rate related. So the patient's doing much better and she has no more symptoms.